I set my keys on the entryway table and crept into Hunter's bedroom without taking my shoes off. I had to see him. It was only 6:30 a.m., so I had another half hour before he got up. But I couldn't wait. My last call had shaken me to my core. The girl never called back. Each minute dragged while I waited for the switchboard to light up with the call, or for my phone to ring, but neither did. Eventually, there was nothing else I could do except go home. Still, it felt wrong.